And the word cult conjures up all sorts of notions of danger, evil, doesn't it?
Yes. It does.
But you're happy for people to think of you as a cult?
No, we are Bible believers. God is telling us what to do. There's nothing about me in this. I am just being a mouthpiece for him.
But you effectively tell the faithful how to live their lives, what clothes to wear, what sort of music to listen to, even which friends they should keep or discard.
No, no. The Bible tells us all of that, tells us the guidelines.
Why do you have to control lifestyle issues, music, clothes, friends? What's that got to do with religious belief?
God's a holy God and hates sin. He's not tainted by sin in any way. So when he wanted to reveal himself to us, he did it in this one book.
But God's not a DJ or a matchmaking counselor or a clothing designer. What's that got to do with it?
God tells us in this book all of that, exactly how he wants us to live, what holiness is. We can't pick and choose what parts of the Bible we want to accept. We have to take it as God gave it and live by that.
What does God say about calling in the real authorities if there's a problem within your group?
Calling in the real authorities. You're talking about...
The police.
The police. Well, the scripture doesn't say to ring the police.
So if one of your members commits a crime, would you automatically call in the police?
Once we're sure that that's happened, yes.
Once you're sure. So you would investigate first?
We don't call on rumors.
So the church would look after it first?
Yes.
And then you would call in the police?
Yeah, so we're going to look into it and make sure that, you know, we've heard correctly and that this is accurate. We will talk to them first and then we will go from there.
So your default position is always your members, the church, and then the real authorities?
I'd do that with you, mate. If somebody said an accusation against you, I don't pick up the phone and start making phone call right away. I check out the facts. I give you a chance to speak up for yourself. You're innocent until proven guilty.
If a husband forces sex upon his wife without her consent, is that rape?
It's wrong.
Is it rape, Pastor?
It's wrong.
Is it criminal?
It's not the right thing to do.
Do you believe rape in marriage is possible or not?
Another line of questioning, please.
Pastor, you have been involved in national counseling seminars. National counseling seminars, weekends for couples, teaching them how to be a good husband and wife. Now, please answer my question.
Another line of questioning, please.
Have you or have you not counseled men and women on how to be good husbands and wives?
We do not sit down like you're describing. I don't call myself a counselor. I preach from the Word of God and from the pulpit what God says about how to have a good marriage, how to be a godly man, godly husband, how to love your wife. I learned some lessons over the years on what that doesn't look like and what it does. As I've looked through the Bible, I find the answers. I teach what God says.